A Kalinia Pradesh Sabha official was tied to a tree in the presence of controversial minister Mervin Silva over his absence at a dengue prevention program in the area last week, media reports revealed. The official who was tied to the tree had told Minister Silva that his child was ill at that time and was unable to attend the program. He had been released later, media reports said.
Hello?
External Affairs Minister G.L. Pires says the proposed biodiversity park in the Western Province has received immense support from the diplomatic community.
Which in many respects are unique to Sri Lanka. They are not to be found in any other part of the world. And any practical program to preserve these natural resources has a far wider significance, transcending the national interest of Sri Lanka. It is of interest globally. Now that is probably the reason why the response of the diplomatic community was so warm and encouraging. About 90% of the high commissioners and ambassadors who were invited to attend the function responded positively to that invitation, and we had a room full of the heads of missions accredited to Colombo.
The minister was speaking at a media briefing held Monday.
And they pledged to take a continuing interest in this project. Many of them asked whether they could help financially, whether they can contribute to this project. They would like to look at the budgets and they would like to make a practical contribution to the success of the project.
The project will be implemented under the guidance of the Western Province.
So we are quite impressed with the response received from our diplomatic community, and the total project cost would be around 14 million US, and this will be implemented for a period of 5 years. So we are confident that we would receive assistance from the diplomatic community through the Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Sri Lanka Private Bus Owners Association says they hope to have a public-private partnership or PPP in the future if the provincial councils fail to regulate the private bus industry on court orders.
මින් ඉදිරියට මේ පළාත් සභාව වලින් හරියට නියාමනයක් වෙන්නේ නැත්නම් මේ බස් කර්මාන්තේ අපි සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම අයින් වෙලා අපි යන්න සැලසුම් කරලා තියෙනවා පෞද්ගලික සහ රාජ්‍ය බස් සේවාව ඒකාබද්ධ ධාවනයක් කරන්න. ඒ කියන්නේ public private partnership එකකට අපි යන්න ඉදිරියේදී සැලසුම් කරන් ඉන්නවා. ඒක තමයි අපි අවසන් සටන.
The initial proposal had been put forward at a meeting held with the Treasury, Transport Ministry and Central Bank last week.
අපි දැන්ට සංගමයක් විදිහට අපි බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන ඉදිරියේදී මේ සම්බන්ධයෙන් අපි පෞගිය සතියේ මහා භාණ්ඩාගාරයත් ඒ වගේම ප්‍රවාහන අමාත්‍යාංශයත් ඒ වගේම මහා බැංකුවත් එක්ක අපි සාකච්ඡා කරලා අපි යෝජනා කීපයක් ඉදිරිපත් කරලා තියෙනවා.
Meanwhile, in a move to expand government transportation, Sri Lanka Transport Board has planned to purchase 100 buses under a leasing scheme. Aviation officials said the Hambantota International Airport will see its first aircraft landing in 2012. According to officials, the runway, which is currently under construction, can accommodate the largest passenger airline in the world, the Airbus A380.
This runway is going to be 3,500 meters in length and 75 meters width. And when we complete this runway in 2012, it will be we are going to construct this runway in such a way where even A380 aircraft can be landing this runway. So that we are proud that we have started this project, and by 2012 we are going to get down the first aircraft. And the first aircraft will be taking off on this particular runway where you are standing right now.
Having an alternative airport in a country is more beneficial. As our Honorable Two Deputy Ministers briefed you earlier, since we don't have alternate proposals, we have to land our aircraft in an emergency in a country like India. So it added the additional cost to the passenger tickets. So in after we after completion of this airport in 2012, we will not be able to face this problem also.
We leave you with some animated visuals of what the Hambantota Airport will look like in 2012. Twycross Zoo in Leicestershire has created an elephant habitat and walkway named Udawala Way. The world-renowned Twycross Zoo aims to promote the conservation of the endangered elephant species through the Udawala Way habitat. Suzanne Boardman, the director of Twycross Zoo, has said that the Udawala Way initiative would help promote the essence of Sri Lanka and attract tourists to the island. Twycross Zoo, which attracts 500,000 visitors each year, will be the first in the world with a Sri Lankan-themed elephant habitat. Emerald International was appointed as the official formal wear provider for Sri Lankan cricket. The new appointment is for a period of 3 years.
One thing that is very important to us is that we prepare like champions and we also appear to dress as champions. And this partnership with Emerald, I hope and I know, will bring this about. Everything that we do as a team, we try and cover all bases, all angles, all contingencies. We try to be as professional as possible. And one of the most important things we always look at is when we go on tour, when we land on a foreign land, about to take on that particular country's cricket team on field, that we arrive looking the part. And therefore, dress and proper dress is very important to us.
The Met Department says there will be showers at several places in the western Sabaragamuwa and central provinces and in Gaul and Mathura districts. Thunder showers will also develop at a few places in the Uwa and eastern provinces during the afternoon or evening.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook.